I'm Dr. Ryan Stanton, and the doc is in. Rabies is an incredibly rare virus, but potential exposure throughout the United States. The most common animals involved are going to be bats, foxes, raccoons, and skunks. Now, the cases associated with rabies are incredibly small, but exposure can be very dangerous. Chloe Dykes was one of those people who recently had an interaction with a bat.
I was just picking weeds after I mowed. And when I went back for the root system of like a fairly large dandelion, I guess a bat was under the leaves. And it was in the dirt, so it was brown. I didn't see it. And when I pulled my hand back up, it was on my finger. And my first thought, since it was still balled up, was that it was like a walnut pinching my finger, which was so strange, but I immediately noticed it was a bat.
Rabies is incredibly challenging because there is no cure for rabies itself. So once somebody has the virus, there is no cure, and it's almost universally fatal. The treatments, however, are nearly 100% protective against developing the disease.
It's like a localized vaccine they put around the wound. And that was like 12 to 15 pricks of them trying to fill my finger with like 2 mLs, I believe. And then they had to put 8 mLs total of that in my body. And then the regular rabies vaccine, which started that day. And then there's three more of those after that first one, so.
The key here is understanding if you have potential exposures and seeking help as soon as possible to get the rabies vaccine, the immune globulin, and all the management that is necessary to make sure that you have a full recovery. You can join the conversation on our Doc is In Facebook page and at Everyday Med on Twitter. I'm Dr. Ryan Stanton, and the Doc is out.